Everyone, today we will discuss about classical TCP improvements. So in last class we have discussed about the problems about the mobility if we use the same traditional TCP in wireless networks, because always mobility itself can lose the packets. So there are many situations like this where mobility itself causes the packet loss. We cannot change traditional TCP completely here. But we can introduce few changes to the TCP just to support mobile users on wireless links. So complete TCP cannot be changed because it is a huge network, and changing of anything to the TCP may introduce problems to the connected fixed networks. So that is the reason we cannot change the TCP completely. But here we have to use the same TCP in the mobile users also, in the mobile network on wireless links also. So together with the introduction of wireless LANs, there are several research projects were started with the goal to increase TCP performance. Means now we have to increase the TCP performance so that it can help mobile users in wireless links. So there are some techniques, there are some improvements have done to the traditional TCP, and that traditional TCP is now used in wireless links also. So that is the first improvement called ITCP. ITCP means indirect TCP. This is the first method introduced in mid-90s after several research projects. Okay, so the following figure shows an example with a mobile host connected via wireless link and an access point to the wide internet where the correspondent host resides. Okay, this is the diagram. Okay, here if you observe the diagram, there is a mobile host which is a wireless link, and an access point is situated in the middle. A standard TCP connection is given to the fixed network. Means from fixed network to wireless network, a packet can be moved. Source can be a fixed network or source can be a wireless network here. Okay. Here, from the fixed network to the access point, standard TCP connection is used. Means a wide network is used. The traditional TCP. Okay, no changes have done to the traditional TCP from fixed network to the access point. In the indirect TCP, whatever the access point is there, which is called as foreign agent, that acts as a mediator between mobile host and standard TCP. Here, standard TCP can also called as indirect TCP or traditional TCP. Okay, so here mainly the two reasons led to the development of indirect TCP. One is TCP will perform poor with the wireless links because it is introduced for fixed networks only. So that is the reason the TCP performs poorly together with the wireless links. And the second one is TCP in the fixed network cannot be changed, because if you change the TCP, as it is a huge network, the changing of a small thing may introduce problem to the fixed network users. So that is why you cannot change the TCP within the fixed network. So these two problems led to the development of indirect TCP, where access point is introduced as a mediator in between mobile host and fixed network. Okay, so here indirect TCP segments TCP connection into a fixed part and also a wireless part. That's the same TCP is now used on the both sides, in wireless and also in fixed network. Here the correspondent node can also use the access point here. Mobile host can also use the access point here to transfer packet from source to the destination. Source can be a mobile host and source can be a fixed network. So to transfer the packet from source to the destination, both fixed network and also wireless network can use this access point. Standard TCP is used between the fixed computer and the access point. That is the traditional TCP. And no computer in the internet recognize any changes to the TCP. Whatever the indirect TCP is used here, that change is not recognized by any other server or any other user in the internet. Instead of the mobile host, the access point now terminates the standard TCP connection, acting as a proxy. Access point will transfer the packet from the fixed network to the mobile host. It can terminate the connection or it can put up the connection here. This means that the access point is now seen as a mobile host for the fixed network and as a fixed host for the mobile host. As it is, access point is acting as a mediator. Whenever mobile host sends a packet to the fixed network, the mobile host sends packet to the fixed network. But in the middle, access point is there. So for mobile host, access point is looks like a destination, because access point is the one which receives the packet, and now mobile host think that it has reached to the destination. So access point will look like a destination to the mobile host. In the same way, if at all fixed network is transmitting the packet, then this access point again looks as a destination for the fixed network. So that is the same written here. The access point is seen as the mobile host for the fixed host and as the fixed host for the mobile host. So between the access point and the mobile host, a special TCP is adapted for wireless links. This wireless TCP is introduced in between mobile host and access point, which acts as a connection between mobile host and foreign agent. This wireless TCP will help to transmit packet from source to the destination using the same standard TCP. So in between mobile host to access point, wireless TCP is used. And in between access point to the fixed network, standard traditional TCP is used. So here, segmenting the connection between mobile host and correspondent host is at the foreign agent. The foreign agent is the segmenting point here. The foreign agent will control all mobility of the mobile host and also mobility in the fixed network also. So whenever handover takes place, whenever packet transmission is done, everything is handled by access point now. So the correspondent host in the fixed network does not notice the wireless link or the segmentation of the connection. Whatever the correspondent host is there, here the fixed network is now called as the correspondent host. Okay, because there should be one host to transmit the packet. So for the fixed host, mobile host is not seen. Whatever the wireless TCP is enabled between mobile host and access point, that is not noticed by the fixed network, that is correspondent node. The foreign agent itself acts as a proxy and relays all data in both directions. So now access point is the mediator, and it has to give the reliable data transfer in both directions, in wireless and also in the standard TCP. If the correspondent host, I am talking about the fixed network here, whenever I say correspondent host means that is a fixed network. If the correspondent host sends the packet, the foreign agent will acknowledge this packet, because for the correspondent host, access point will look like the destination. So now foreign agent, after receiving the packet from the correspondent host, it acknowledges the packet and tries to forward the packet to the mobile host. Soon after receiving the packet, the first thing foreign agent will do is sending the acknowledgement to the correspondent host. After sending acknowledgement to the correspondent host, foreign agent will now transmit the packet to the mobile host. If the mobile host receives the packet, it acknowledges the packet to the foreign agent, not directly to the correspondent host. This acknowledgement is only used by the foreign agent. Whatever the acknowledgement mobile host has sent, that acknowledgement is used by the foreign agent. That acknowledgement will not be transmitted to the correspondent host, because already after receiving the packet, access point foreign agent already gave an acknowledgement. But if a packet is lost on the wireless link due to transmission error, I am talking about the wireless link. Okay, if at all packet is lost on the wireless link due to transmission error, the correspondent host would not notice this, because already foreign agent gave the acknowledgement. Whenever it receives the acknowledgement, it will think that packet is reached to its destination without any packet loss. So that is why correspondent host would not notice this. So what happens in this case? The foreign agent tries to retransmit the packet locally. After transmitting the packet from access point to mobile host, foreign agent still keeps the packet with it. If at all packet loss is seen between foreign agent to the mobile host, then foreign agent again tries to retransmit the packet, because it is the responsibility of the foreign agent to transmit the packet at any cost, as it already given acknowledgement to the fixed network. So that is the reason foreign agent will now tries to retransmit the packet to maintain the reliable data transport. Similarly, if the mobile host send the packet now, okay, the foreign agent acknowledges this packet to the mobile host. Soon after receiving the packet from the mobile host, foreign agent will send the acknowledgement to the mobile host that I have received the packet. After this, foreign agent will now tries to transmit the packet to the correspondent host. It will send the to the correspondent host. After reaching the packet, correspondent host will gives the acknowledgement to the foreign agent. But this acknowledgement will not be transferred to the mobile host, because mobile host already received the acknowledgement from the access point when it received the packet. So this is the case when mobile host sends the packet. If at all, again, packet is lost on the wireless link when mobile host is transmitting the packet on the wireless link. If at all packet is lost, the mobile host will notice this much faster due to the lower round trip time, because mobile host will be knowing at what time packet will be reached to the access point. Every data will be given by the router, that this is the source address, this is the destination address, packet will reach to the destination. If at all packet is not reaching to the destination at the given time, then mobile host identifies the problem that packet is lost in the middle and tries to retransmit the packet again. This retransmission of packet is done by mobile host on the wireless link. Whereas if you look at the correspondent host, if packet is lost, correspondent host will not retransmit the packet, but access point will retransmit the packet. In mobile host case, if packet is lost, directly mobile host will retransmit the packet, because mobility is much faster when compared to the wide network, and mobility is the thing where you can get all the details about round trip time, socket, pairing, everything. So now mobile host will directly retransmit the packet to the access point. Here, indirect TCP requires several actions as soon as handover takes place. If packet loss is there, then these are the solution. Now we are talking about the handover, means if mobile host is moving to another place, that time what happens? Here only one access point is there. Now access point will transmit the packet to the mobile host. But if mobile host is not in its home location, if it is moving to the foreign location, then it will become a problem to the access point to transmit the packet to the mobile host. So not only the packets have to be redirected, but every socket, proxy, addresses, ports, everything have to be redirected. Everything have to be buffered here. So now the access point acts as a proxy and buffers the packet for retransmission if mobile host move to the foreign network. Okay, let us see if you are having diagram. For the diagram, if I put this and explain about the diagram, it will be difficult. So that is why I am giving the diagram slide only. For your notes, I am showing. Note explanation for this. Okay. So this is, I am talking about this handover. Now mobile host is moved to the another location. Another location means which is not its home location, it is its foreign location. So here now the wide network, the correspondent host, will transmit the packet to the mobile host. And whenever packet has reached to the access point will gives the acknowledgement to the correspondent host. After giving acknowledgement to the correspondent host, access point will now tries to transmit the packet to the mobile host. But when trying to transmit the packet to the mobile host, it identifies that mobile host has moved to the another location. So what it will do? Until it gets registered to the another foreign location. If mobile host is moving to another location, it has to register with the foreign network. We have discussed about the registration, reply, all these things in previous classes. Okay. Soon after registering with the new foreign network, the foreign network now transmits the data, details about the mobile host to the previous access point. That your device, your mobile device has now came to my location and now we have registered. This is the new location of the mobile host. These are the details sent by the new foreign agent to the old access point. So soon after receiving this information, access point will buffer the packet to the another new foreign access point to transmit the data to the mobile host which is now staying in the new foreign location. Okay. Mobile host is moved to the another foreign location. It will register with that foreign agent. After registering, foreign agent will transmit the data, details about the mobile host to the old foreign agent or old home agent, that your device have come to my place and now registered with me. After receiving these details about the mobile host, this home agent or foreign agent will buffers the packet to the new location of the mobile host. Okay. In between this buffering, access point, the new access point will now acts as a mediator. Directly the first access point, here first access point means access point 2. Okay, this access point will transmit the data to the another access point which is written as access point 1, or you can directly from there, from access point to access point, access point 1 to access point 2. Okay. Access point 1. I will tell about access point 1 only. Correspondent host will transmit the packet to the access point 1. Access point 1 will give acknowledgement to the correspondent host. Now access point 1 will try to transmit the packet to the mobile host, but mobile host is moved to another location. So this access point 1, after receiving details about the mobile host, will transmit the packet to the access point 2. Access point 1 will not directly send the packet to the mobile host, but access point 1 will transmit the packet to the access point 2. And now access point 2 will transmit buffers the packet to the mobile host. This is how packet is transmitted to the destination if at all handovers will take place. Means after the handover, the old proxy must forward buffered data to the new proxy because it has already acknowledged the data. The sockets of the proxy should also migrate to the new foreign located area in the access point. Socket means it consists of six sequence numbers, addresses. Addresses means source address, destination address. Ports also, source port, destination port. Socket, a single socket pair will consist of all these details. When handover takes place, socket migration is also will take place. Soon after socket migration, details of the mobile host is given to the access point. Agents. Now agents will buffer the packet to the mobile host. Okay, so here no new connection is established for the mobile host, and correspondent host must not see any changes in the connection's state. So in between access point and correspondent node, a standard indirect traditional TCP is used without giving any trouble in the wireless link, and between mobile host to the access point, a wireless TCP is used without giving any problems on the fixed network. This is how indirect TCP will work in order to transmit the packet from fixed network to the mobile host without disturbing. During the handover, the buffered packet as well as the system state must have to migrate to the new agent. If socket migration will not take place, then data buffering also will not take place. So that is why socket migration here plays a major role. Okay, this is about indirect TCP, which is introduced in order to avoid problems like poor performance of TCP if used together with the wireless link, and TCP in the fixed network cannot be changed completely just for the mobility. So for these problems, a solution is given by the indirect TCP. This is how indirect TCP will work. In next classes, we will discuss about advantages and disadvantages of indirect TCP. Thank you.